Okay, jokes aside, this is not what happened. I mean, I know it kind of looks like a spaceship, but it actually isn't. It's still very interesting, so keep watching.
Becky, remember, we're testing Drive Pilot, not your driving skills.
In the old days, cars had to be powerful, fast, spacious, beautiful, and comfortable. All the attributes that Mercedes-Benz traditionally stands for. These days, they also have to be smart and intelligent too. Yes, I'm talking about digital features, AI, apps, all of it.
So today, we're here to test just how smart Mercedes-Benz cars really are and meet some of the smartest people around this company. So hop in the car with us, we'll take you for a ride.
So they gave us a new E-Class to showcase some of the technology and intelligence that goes into these cars. Where do we even start?
I think I might know someone that can help us out.
Okay.
Hey, Leonie.
Hey, how are you doing?
We want to check out how smart these cars really are. What should we do?
Yeah, I have a cute idea for you. Come to Sindelfingen and visit me and I will show you Drive Pilot.
Yeah, let's head there.
All right, let's go. Let's map it. Hey, Mercedes.
How may I help you?
Take me to the center of excellence.
I am calculating the route.
Wait, before I go, let me just adjust my mirrors. All right, let's go.
Nice.
Oh, there's Leonie. Let's go. One and done. Beautiful. Good morning.
Hey, good morning.
So tell us about this. I mean, is this an autonomous car?
Drive Pilot is our world first level 3 system for Mercedes. We introduced it in 2021 with 60 kilometers per hour, and we will extend the speed in the next year up to 95 kilometers per hour.
I guess my big question is, as a driver, why? Why introduce autonomous driving into everyday cars?
So our Drive Pilot, you can do several things while sitting in the car, like watch a movie or even do emails, read a book, just enjoy your time. We want to give back time to the customer.
Wow. So level 3, are there different levels to this?
Elly Explains.
So let's look at the levels of autonomous driving real quick. This is where it all begins. At this level, the driver is fully in control. No advanced driver assistance system needed at all. Then there's level 1, which means there's a certain level of driver assistance system active, like adaptive cruise control. But the driver must stay engaged and monitor the road at all times. Level 2 stands for partial automation. That means the car can handle 2 or more tasks simultaneously, like steering and acceleration. But again, the driver must remain ready to take over. Level 3 means conditional automation. The car can handle most driving tasks and even make decisions. The driver must still be ready to intervene when prompted. Level 4, now we're talking about the future. The car can perform all relevant tasks in a predefined environment. A driver is not needed anymore. And then there's level 5, which means that the car, no matter what, can handle any scenario with any weather in any environment at any time. But before Mercedes-Benz brings a new level of autonomous driving to the streets, there have been years of research and development to not only make sure it's functioning, but also refine to their high standards. So where does that take place and how does it work? We went to the Mercedes-Benz Technology Center to find out.
Hi, Steffi.
Hi.
Whereabouts are we? And what is that? It looks like a spaceship.
Yeah, well, it's not. So it's our moving-based driving simulator. And you are in Sindelfingen at Mercedes-Benz.
Amazing.
This thing looks crazy. And one of the things I'm thinking of is it's such heavy-duty equipment. How much does this actually weigh?
What do you think?
I'm going to say 10 tons.
Let's say 50.
So it's exactly in between. It's 23 tons.
Oh, it's actually way more than I thought it was going to be. And it looks like it's on like a huge sliding rail? Is this so it can move like left or right?
Yeah, so this is a 12 meter linear glider. And it's with very low friction because it's air bearing.
Okay.
So like a hovercraft, maybe, you know.
Yeah.
There you see the hexapod with the six actors, and you have the couple on the top, and this is made of carbon.
Wow.
And you have a real car inside and 360 degree view. If you just change little things in the models that we drive, then you will actually feel with your butt.
What situations are you trying to simulate here? Is it just everyday driving, or is it everything all the way up to performance driving as well?
Yeah, there are two main focuses we have. The first one is the vehicle dynamics.
Yep.
So if you have virtual models of cars that are not even built now, you can drive them here. So this is mainly done by our experts. And the second big thing is our driver assistance system studies. And there you have real people coming here and doing experiments with us, with a focus on user experience, usability, acceptance, and for sure safety.
You can check out the ESC, the electronic stability controls, in a car using this simulator.
Yeah, you can do.
So could you technically drift it?
No.
Oh, well, that's me. Coming for you. Okay.
I'd love to have a go at this. Are we able to try this out today?
For sure, if you want to be one of our test customers.
Absolutely. Let's go.
Yeah?
Gunner.
Let's go.
So how does it know that we're on the highway? Is that the GPS system from above?
Yes, so we use map data. We have a precise map here. And we use the positioning system to see on which lane you're driving.
How long did it take to develop this technology?
4 to 5 years. So
wow.
4 to 5 years to the first step.
Oh, whoa, yeah. Ooh. Okay, yeah, cool. All right, let's go. Oh, shh. She sounds like she's got a V8 in there. That's good news. All right. So can I go over the lane?
Sure.
Woo-hoo. Okay, let's go over a lane. Meow. Into the Autobahn. Flat. Oh.
So we also have a police detection or a blue light detection with a camera which goes to the rear. So emergency vehicle detection.
Yeah, easy. I'm fine.
I would laugh if it's just 130. You should also see that in your instrument, that it's the allowed speed.
It says 130.
Yeah, but you are driving 240 now.
This is your very first Autobahn and you're not even driving it.
Yeah, no, first time driving in Europe, first time driving the Autobahn, and first time not driving. While driving for the first time in Europe, driving the Autobahn. Does that make sense?
Yeah, kind of.
Sounds weird.
It's very gentle, actually. Do you know what? I was expecting it to be more like, I'm like rocking it back and forth, but I feel like I'm rocking my eyeballs in my head, which is strange.
This is a very big moment for me. Like it's, yeah, this is insane.
So now you can see the white lights on your steering wheel.
Yes.
Go for activation.
Okay.
Oh my God, I'm in traffic.
Maybe if the drive pilot is available, you can switch it on.
Drive pilot, okay.
Press the button.
Yes.
Release pedals.
Now confirm and enjoy.
Yeah. Yo, no way.
Oh my gosh. How's the feeling?
No, but actually.
How's the feeling? Enjoy. Now, we are in drive pilot mode, so you have the blue lane marking everywhere. You see the 95 with the blue markings. You see the blue lights on your steering wheel.
So it's keeping a certain distance from the car ahead, is that right?
Yes, that's totally right.
The directions are in German.
Yeah, that's okay. Drive pilot is Angelfort, bitte mit okay test, yeah.
Now you do not need to use the pedals anymore, because if you use the acceleration or the braking pedal, then you will switch it off.
Look at that. Now what do I do?
So now we are able to do whatever you like. So we can play either games. In Germany, you are also allowed to use your phone. So we can read.
This feels like, I'm like in the
back. You feel safe.
I'm in the back going like, oh, okay. All right, this is new.
Wow.
Okay, let's go for something.
Can we play a little game?
Yeah, for sure.
I'm
what
a gamer.
Would you like to do? So I like memory.
This is crazy. I can't get over the fact that actively you're okay to just play games and the car
and
is
look
gonna
away.
Take, and yeah, let's it's take crazy, your eyes away.
Becky, remember, we're testing Drive Pilot, not your driving skills.
Okay. I will let someone else drive for me.
She's such a driver.
I wouldn't be very good at this, though, because I need to do something when it's all happening.
This is
so weird. Even when you're turning around, I just sit watching your hand.
I think it's fabulous.
I wonder one day if they'll be able to make a car that drifts itself. That'd be so cool.
Another exciting day at Mercedes-Benz come to an end. And what did we learn? That there's a lot of great people putting in the work to create and refine that special Mercedes-Benz feeling for the driver.
Well, now we're a lot smarter. It's quite impressive what Mercedes-Benz cars are already capable of. And what's even more intriguing is what's coming in the future.